My current journey, and all the events to come, are due to a letter from my old friend Victor Frankenstein. Victor is a brilliant scientist, obsessed with the idea of helping people overcome the fear of death by finding the secret of eternal life. His letter is filled with worries and concerns, as well as the hope that I will help him. While he does not actually explain what's going on in the letter, he promises that all will become clear for me as soon as I arrive, if I will only come. It's obvious the letter is of great import, and I leave for a place he has mentioned immediately. When I arrive, Victor has assured me that he and his young wife, Elizabeth, will be there to meet me.
My efforts to discover the secret of eternal life seriously undermined my finances. But when I was on the brink of bankruptcy, a miracle happened. Quite unexpectedly, I made the acquaintance of a man named Baron Igor von Zinden. The Baron is well-versed in science, and what is more, exceedingly wealthy. Since he was fascinated by my ideas, Baron von Zinden not only agreed to finance my investigations, but also proposed that he become my assistant. Thanks to the generous financing from Baron Igor, I was able to create a miraculous machine. Its mechanism can reanimate dead bodies and even support life in them by means of electromagnetic pulses passing through the flesh. I'm ready to begin in vivo experiments.
Elizabeth, can you hear me? Wake up!
My dear friend, it's you. It's so very kind of you to have answered our plea for help. Terrible things are happening here. We are all in the greatest peril. It is genius. My spouse has created a monstrous evil.
Thank you.
The experiments with dead rats produce greatly contradictory results. While all the reanimated rats have supernatural physical strength, much stronger than that of regular rats, the reanimated animals suffer greatly from terrible pain, and as a result, behave extremely aggressively. Yet when I decided to halt the lives of these pathetic creatures and end their suffering, the Baron persuaded me not to do so. Instead, he told me he had a recipe for a remedy that would release the test subjects from their suffering without killing them.
Thank you.
First, Igor insisted on experimenting on the body of a dead person, but I managed to dissuade him from that madness. Still, he persuaded me to experiment on large animals and said he had a drug to relieve their suffering. I'm afraid even to ask him where he got the corpse of a tiger from. Indeed, I'm beginning to doubt the man is sane.